Hello, everybody. Today I wanted to talk about my overall ranking of Jane Austen's main six novels. So I'm going to talk about my favorites, and again, I'm going to try to keep this spoiler-free like I have my last few, so I'm going to try not to give away too much of the story, but I'm just going to talk a little bit about why I like them in the order that I like them. Now, this is hard for me to actually do a distinct ranking. I kind of have a bottom three and a top three, and so I love all of Austen's novels. There's not one of them that I dislike, so it's difficult to actually just say, oh, this is her worst book and this is her best book for me, because I think they're all fantastic. But my bottom three, let me just show you what they are. Emma, Persuasion, and Sense and Sensibility. And the main reason with these being my bottom three is that these are ones that every time I've read them, I've had drastically different opinions. So I'll go back and forth where one time reading them, I think it's fantastic and my favorite. And then the next time I read it, I have a lot of just nitpicky things that drive me crazy. And so that kind of drops it down. And so these are ones that I have read multiple times, but that every time, I kind of fluctuate quite a bit. Which I appreciate. I think that that's a good thing. And probably just kind of shows different points of my life and what's going on in my life. So Emma might be my least favorite. I'm not really sure. I think that there's a lot of interesting stuff discussed in Emma, and it has a lot of interesting characters. Not really that many likable characters. There are a few though. And I don't know, there's a lot of interesting interactions and different types of people coming together here. So I think it's an interesting one to discuss, but because there are not as many characters that I feel like I can connect with and love, I think that that's one reason this one is in my bottom three. And then with Persuasion, and I'm not particularly talking about these in order of least to greatest here, just what the bottom three are and why. With Persuasion, again, it's one that I've gone back and forth a lot with. So when I read it years ago, at one point it was my favorite Austen for a while, and then when I've reread it, I didn't like it quite as much, and then I reread it and loved it, and then I read it again and it was just okay. So it's had a lot of changes within it. Now I do think that it beautiful writing, and I do think that you can see kind of a change from some of her earlier stuff to this. The last time that I read it, which was last year, I know that I had some problems with how it was paced. It felt like it's not very long. It felt like the first half of it is just like this elaborate setup for there to be the second half, which then kind of goes into actually how these characters are feeling and things. So it felt too much like a setup for me, and the story, even though yes, stuff was happening and there was progression and things, it just didn't feel like it was paced extremely well. And so I felt like there was too much setup for then a lot of great stuff. So first half of it, the last time I read it, I didn't enjoy as much. And then the second half, I was like, oh, this is fantastic. Like it's flowing really well. So I think a lot of this one is just the mood that I'm in at the moment when I pick it up. Sometimes that really works for me and sometimes it doesn't. But it is a fantastic book. And then Sense and Sensibility, as I've probably mentioned in my other ranking videos for the different characters, I find it forgettable in a lot of ways. There are a lot of things that I appreciate about it. I went through a phase where I was kind of mad at this book because I read it. I took a British novel class when I was in college, and I wrote a paper on a possible sequel. I was writing about how Jane Austen might have intended to do a sequel to Sense and Sensibility, and I just spent a lot of time with this novel, and I think that I annoyed myself in doing that. And so for a long time I just didn't want to pick it up after that. And then when I did, I was like, oh, this is a lot better than I remembered it being. But again, this one just doesn't stick in my mind as much as the others. So this one I find a little more forgettable, even though I still think it's fantastic and it has great characters and there's a lot of interesting character interactions within it that I really appreciate. So, great book, just compared to some of the others, I do find it a bit more forgettable to me. And then my top three, in no specific order at the moment, Mansfield Park, Pride and Prejudice, and Northanger Abbey. And that probably is my order of preference of these. These three I rank as my top three again, because mostly because I find that every time I've read them, now I haven't read Mansfield Park as much as most of the others, but every time that I have read them, I have enjoyed them as much or more on rereading. So there's not that fluctuation in my thoughts. I just find new things and new things to think about and appreciate. So with Mansfield Park, I again mentioned probably in my video about the heroines, Fanny Price. I think she's fantastic. And I just find a lot of the family dynamics and things in here explored in really interesting ways. And I just appreciate seeing a different type of heroine in comparison to some of the others. So I really like Mansfield Park, and I would like to reread it soon because it's been a while. And again, this one is one of my least read Austen, so I would like to read it more and kind of get more into that study. But one of my favorites. Pride and Prejudice, from an objective standpoint, I think that Pride and Prejudice is Jane Austen's best novel. I think that it has the best development, character development from beginning to end. It flows the best, honestly. And so I think from an objective standpoint, this is the best Jane Austen novel that there is. It's just fantastic. I really love it. There's fantastic character development from beginning to end. And that's true of both like Elizabeth, Mr. Darcy, but also the rest of the characters, the side characters, and we really get to see the way that they change or the way that perceptions change when, things about different characters are revealed. And so I really appreciate that, and I just really love this book. Probably my most read Jane Austen book. It's fantastic. And then Northanger Abbey, again, I've probably mentioned this in my ranking of the heroines, but I just find this one really enjoyable. I like the, satire of the gothic novel and seeing everything kind of flipped around and played with. I think that's really fun. I appreciate seeing, this younger work of Austen and what she was trying to do even, back then when she was writing this. I like Catherine Morland and Henry Tilney and their relationship. And I just like seeing her experiencing these new things, and it's just really funny. And seeing how her imagination gets carried away and kind of leads her into some not great situations, and how she kind of has to deal with that. And it plays with that gothic novel and kind of flips it around in interesting ways. And I just really, really enjoy that. It's also not extremely long, so pretty quick read, which can sometimes be a bonus. But yeah, I just love it. So again, I love all of Jane Austen's books. They're fantastic, but those are my bottom three and my top three, and some of the reasoning as to why I like them in the orders that I like them. So let me know, what is your favorite Jane Austen book? What's your least favorite? Have you read them all? Do you want to read them all? Let me know what your thoughts are about Jane Austen's books, and I will see you in my next video.